What if I told you don't have to waste a billion bottles to have a honey farm? Ooh, and I need to change up this landscape. Ah, much better. Hey guys, no surprise, Cremulous here, back with a new tutorial. And I'm just kidding, I'm not gonna make you suffer with this background. Okay, so to get started, I'm just going to jump right into what we're looking at here. I'm not going to talk to you today about a new bee farm or anything like that. What I'm going to do is show you a way that you can build a honey farm without using a million bottles. Now, these two farms are super well known. It's difficult to improve on this honeycomb variation at all. It's so compact, small, easy to use. There's several examples out there for both of these. In case you are interested in these, I'll share as many tutorials as I can find, but they're pretty simple. I'm hoping just pausing the video here and pausing the video here, you can see how to make these on your own. But while it's very difficult to improve on the honeycomb variation of this, one of the major problems with the honey variation is that you have to fill this dispenser with empty bottles. And that's because the dispenser picks a slot out of here at random. And let's put a button on here. Oops, my bees got out. No worries. We don't need them in there anyway. So you can see it comes out of different stacks. So there's no way to predict which it's going to come out of. And if one of these is empty and it dispenses, but it'll actually put the honey bottle there. And you might think to yourself, well, that's not that big of a deal. What if I just put a stack of bottles in here and then just let these fill up with honey? Well, that's great. But as soon as this is finally full, once this is full, if it happens to pick a honey bottle, it'll just dispense it and put it out into your hopper. Your bee nest will still be full and your farm will break. It won't automatically collect anymore. So you have to keep it full. You don't necessarily have to keep it completely full, right? But you're going to need to keep a few in here, right? And that you have a risk of this after only just seven. If it happens to pick the exact same slot seven times in a row, then after seven bottles, it'll break again. So you really need to keep it full for optimum performance on this. And who really wants to waste nine stacks of bottles permanently in your any honey farm? So like I said, I'm going to show you, just jump right into what I'm going to show you. This is the money shot. This is the thing you're here to care about. If you're one of those people like me who wants to just jump into the tutorial, look at the thing, go build it. This is what you want. This is when you where you want to pause it right here. I'm going to quickly go into an explanation of this. Then I'm going to walk through some of the steps and some of the learnings that I had in this process. I'm going to make this a super short tutorial, I hope. But this is it. This is the thing you're going to need. Now, let me walk you through how this works. So let's build it. Let's build a traditional honey farm. Actually, let's just look at the one we've got here. So the way this works, you've got a nest or a hive. It's got bees in it. They come out. You saw the ones came out earlier. I don't know if they've come back. Doesn't really matter. This guy's out here now. So they go in and out, fill up the honey. It has five stages of being full, and each one gives out one additional strength of redstone signal. So you can see that in the dust here. This is at three right now. It'll probably go up here shortly with that bee going in there. Finally, it'll power this stone that'll power the dispenser. And at that time, the nest will be full. The empty bottle will fill with honey. It can't put it anywhere back in the dispenser, so it just drops it. It's picked up by this hopper. We might get to see it right here. I'm just gonna wait here just a second to see if we can see it. There's some empty bottles and three honey in there right now. There it goes. So you saw it really quick. The signal strength went to this block, powered the dispenser. We should look in here now and see four honey bottles and four glass bottles. Again, the glass bottles won't be in here. I think that just was left over for me playing around. So how do we improve on this? So the problem is we want to get to where we can have this dispenser. We want to be able to have just a single glass bottle in there, right? We want to be able to somehow put one bottle in here. And when it fills up with honey, it would put it back in here as a honey bottle. Let's pretend this bee nest is full. I can't just simulate a full nest, unfortunately. So when this fires against a full nest, it'll end up with a honey bottle in it. So if you look at this style, if you build it in reality, in your world, you're probably gonna come up with something like this, right? Because you wanna build an enclosure, something that you think is pretty to keep the bee in. So what I came up with is actually this, we'll skip over a couple of these here. It's actually this guy right here, okay? And I'll show you really briefly what's happening. I changed the dispenser to, rather than in the original version, the dispenser is above the bee nest. I actually put the dispenser below. And that gives me the opportunity to put an item filter underneath it. So as you see, there's one glass bottle in the dispenser. Underneath the dispenser is this item filter. So what's gonna happen is when this is full, this chain, as you see, five redstone signal is actually gonna power this redstone dust, five of them, power the bee nest, and through the bee nest, it'll power the dispenser. The dispenser then grabs the honey out of the bottle, puts it back into here. The hopper picks it up because the item filter allows it now. That continues through the chain and it comes out into this chest. Now, the clever thing about this, if I may humbly call it that, in this line, I'm filling it with a dropper. And this dropper is full, right? It doesn't have to be, right? I can put as few in here as I want. If I've only got a half a stack of bottles, I can stick that in there. And what happens is, once this fills, the chain will completely break. So this will be unpowered, right? Because once the honey's taken out, there's no redstone signal. When it does get the first stage of redstone signal, it's going to power this first bit of redstone. And when it does that, it powers this dropper. This dropper puts one bottle into this hopper, which continues unimpeded into the dispenser. And then we wait until the next four stages, and it powers and it repeats. And if you compare these two, the difference in complexity between this and this is really not much, especially if you're already familiar with item filters. And for me, I don't know if you're like me, this isn't going to be a solution for everyone. For a lot of people, glass is disposable. But for me, I hate wasting it, especially if you tile it. I really wanted a way to avoid that. Now I can control how many I put in here. I can still make shulkers and shulkers of bottles if I want and use this system. But the point is that I don't have to. This is still really, really cheap if it's early in the game or I don't want to waste four shulkers of glass on a system like this. But this will work with as few as one bottle in this backdropper. But I think you're going to want a few more than that, right? But a stack, right? You can distribute a stack among eight. As slow as these hives are in a day, you wait a couple of days, you just distribute the stack across eight of these and you get a stack of bottles out. And you come check it every so often. You don't have to waste all those bottles and they don't have to get stuck in here forever. That's really what it was about. So to get back into it, this is too wide tileable, but you can build something that looks like this. It's pretty simple, right? I did add this this extra hopper minecart feeder just for demonstration. You can ignore that if you want. As you can see, it's the exact same setup we've got in here. Powers the dropper. And because it's too wide tileable, I brought the hoppers out to the side. The reason being, when this block is powered, the hoppers can't feed in. It doesn't actually break the system, but I like the idea that it can just completely flow in there at will. Then underneath, they all come into a single line here and then into whatever system you use. I've currently got it in a dropper elevator into this honey chest, and then I can put my empty bottles in here. Now, the initial design, if we can see that it's too wide tileable, I can actually move this dispenser to the side, and that's what I did in this setup right here, right? So the dispenser is beside the honey. Out the back, I'm checking the fill level, and because I have to power the dispenser next to the bee nest, I have to move it over, and that actually creates a potential for interference. If I move this redstone here, then when this is fully powered, it'll actually power that block, and that's not what we want. It would drop the bottle. So I had to route it like this, but you could tile it like this if you want. And it works just the same. You can still put your item filter under it as well, but this is just a little bit messier, right? This system is a controllable way to drop a single item into your chain in an easy way. And I'm a much, much bigger fan of this look than this look. But again, either will work. So now I'm going to talk a little bit about some of the mechanics I ran into. This should be, theoretically, one wide tileable, right? Because if I put two of these side by side, just like this, you know, imagine the redstone lines running across here. Right, so that would be a power two, same as the one, three, four, five. You would think that I could just put these next to each other as much as I want. However, quasi-connectivity raises its head again. If I have a dispenser there and a dispenser here, all right, and I've got bee nests on top of each, and I've got dust just under this one, you would expect when I power this bee nest, it's going to spit out a bee nest, right? Great, that's awesome. That one also spits out a bee nest. And the reason it didn't fire it immediately is because it had quasi-connectivity and never received an update. That means it is impossible. It is impossible to tile it like this. You can't possibly power this bee nest without also powering this dispenser. And so I was running into major issues where that would happen. So I did find a way to tile it. I'm going to show it to you now. You can stagger them, but it's more complicated. It does work though. I've been running it for hours and hours and hours, and it's doing great. So this is how it looks. I use sunflowers. I really should have faced east. To make this a lot more of an impact. But as you can also see, the back is much, much more complicated. And that's because we've got all this issue with interference. So there's two places where it happens. The dispenser itself that's collecting the honey, those can't be side by side, as well as these droppers in the line. They can't be side by side. So the build actually looks exactly the same up to this point. But the problem is, at the very top, these guys all have to terminate. They have to hit their fifth power all on the same line. So I have to go from staggered to a straight line up here. There is no other way to do this that I can find. Maybe with a dropper hopper counter. I couldn't find a more compact way to do this. This was the best that I could find. But if you're interested, if you want to make this tileable, if you want to have control over your bottle usage, this is the way to do it. Now, there is one caveat. There is tremendous diminution of returns on this, because to get out of this long chain of things happening to keep the signal separated, you have to use a lot of hoppers. So it's four hoppers per. They're not that expensive. And to be honest, I would much rather make hoppers than I would bottles. I won't ever reuse bottles. I'll reuse hoppers. So they're here if I need them. And iron is cheaper than glass. You know, I can farm that. Sand, I've got a mine and then smelt. But I have to put this huge chain of hoppers in here, as well as there's an issue with this. If you run more than 9 of these, the signal that's going to come out of one of these when it's full is 5. So you have a signal of 5 right here. That actually powers all the way across here. It doesn't matter because it, in terms of collecting the honey, because it won't ever power the dispensers. That means while any one of these, this guy is powered, this line of hoppers right here, these hoppers will almost always be completely powered. And I didn't find a solution to that. I think there probably is a solution. That being said, even without using this feeding system, if you just come in here and feed your hoppers manually, this system works great. So you could just take out all of the hoppers below this, replace them with glass. And I do see the irony in not wanting to use glass and then using glass for my redstone, but I use that for the tutorial for it's easy to see. You could use slabs or any non-conductive block in that place. I'm just going to go ahead and remove all this and see if it looks any better. I'll be right back. There you have it. It's a very, very, very simple system, relatively speaking, if you don't want item distribution, to build a very compact, tileable farm that doesn't force you to fill all the dispensers with bottles. That's 72 full sacks of bottles you would have to use in these systems. Then you've got all the bottles you want to use to collect the honey. You have to create a ton of bottles for a big farm. All right, guys, I'm going to call it right there. It went a little bit longer than I expected. I went into explaining the one wide system a little more than maybe needed. But hopefully for all you impatient like I am, this screen right here, that's all you really need. That's the tutorial right there, or at the 2-minute mark. But if you did enjoy this, click that like button, show me some love, hit that subscribe button if you really want to see more. I'll keep making videos as they come to me, but I do really appreciate the feedback. And I'll be implementing this system in my world, Aglanada, which I work on stream on Twitch. Come over there and check me out. We have a really good time. Otherwise, I'll see you the next time I post a video. And thank you for watching. Get along, little doggy.